how to maintain the home language and also why it's important. So this topic is largely like conceptual, but I also have a measurable objective for you guys. And it's going to be students will be able to understand the importance of supporting a child's home language, but also being able to identify appropriate ways of working with families in order to do that. So I'm going to open up to you guys. Why do you guys think it's important to maintain the home language for an ELL student? You guys can talk in pairs for a second. A good way in order to maintain the language. What did you guys say?
We just kind of talked about the same thing, just that also if they're still able to use their home language, they'll feel a little bit more comfortable rather than just like, all right, now I have to learn this new language. They can still go back to what they're comfortable with.
Exactly. There's actually a lot of benefits for children that are bilingual and students that are maintaining two languages. So one of those things is academic success. Students that are learning or that are grounded in two languages actually have higher achievement in literacy and math. They have better thinking skills. We talked a lot about brain plasticity early in the semester. And when you know two languages, your brain's actually organized in a different way. And it drives functional plasticity. And so they have better critical thinking skills. They have better problem solving skills. And their brains are active and they're flexible. They also can transfer the skills from their first language or their home language into the second language that they're learning, being that language is English. Some more benefits are that there's long-term success for bilingual individuals. They have a better likelihood of getting a job, and they have a better opportunity of participating in the global market. The first language is also helps to maintain their identity, especially if their family has a different ethnicity or culture from other students in their class. It's really important for their social and emotional development to maintain that language and to maintain that part of their identity. And it also helps them to maintain links to their family and their community if they're living in a community that's really rich in a certain culture. So being that there are so many benefits to being a bilingual learner, why do you think that it's not necessarily pushed for in schools to have students be continually maintaining that first language? That's true, you do need a really solid team in order to maintain the whole language.
Can you talk about how the resources are? They might not have a lot of support for
child. And I'm glad you guys brought up resources and money, because that's something that I didn't necessarily focus on. So I think it's important you guys are thinking about that. Things that I kind of brought up is kind of just like common phrases and things that people say that we kind of don't even kind of take as true, but they're things that are said all the time. And for example, like, this is America, we should be speaking English. That's something we hear all the time, and it's not true, and it's something that research suggests, we talked about in other presentations, that this white mainstream majority is actually, in the future, not going to be the majority. So So it's something that we have to accept as these other cultures and ethnicities accepting it and making sure that we are supporting students that are not speaking English as their first language. Also that mainstream Americans or those who hold power are primarily speaking English. This does go back into the first point in saying that the English language is not the language of America or the United States, and we have to make sure that we are supporting the first language, whether it be Spanish or Chinese, like you guys mentioned before. And also another common misconception is that when students are speaking their native language in English simultaneously, that it's going to be taking away from them learning English and becoming proficient in English. Because research suggests that if a student is maintaining their first language while learning English, the skills that they learn in their first language transfer over and they actually are more, they become more proficient in English and they do a better job in their reading achievement. So, in order to do that, why do you guys think that family is a central part to maintaining the home language? Why do you guys think that having a connection with family would be really important in doing this? Exactly. One of the things that I read, which I thought was really impactful, was that what parents value, students will value. And so if you have a strong communication with families and they don't feel isolated because English isn't their first language and you form a bond with them, they will want to value the teacher's values in the sense of promoting the proficiency in English. And just a strong communication with families is so important in order to get them comfortable with participating in the school. And also, if they feel comfortable with the teacher and what the teacher's values are, then they're more likely to support their student at home. Also, families can share information about your students that you would not know otherwise, and it could be vital to your teaching. And if you don't maintain this communication with them, you might miss out on information that's really important. And also teaching children of their heritage and their culture and their values is something that they should be proud of and should maintain that in your classroom. So we're going to talk about what teachers and parents can do. So parents over the summer or during the school year, they can always have their students read books in their first language or have them watch TV shows or movies in their first language just so they're constantly hearing their home language. Also, they can encourage students to write to family members or relatives that are still living in the country of their first language, and that's a way that they can maintain their writing skills. Teachers could look for events in the community that cultivate and promote their culture and their ethnicity and get them to own their identity and get them to like kind of claim their heritage as something to be proud of. And parents can continue speaking the first language even after students become proficient in English. And that's really important because of what we talked about, all the benefits of being bilingual. If the speaking of the first language stops once a student becomes proficient in English, then they kind of lose out on that long-term success and competing kind of in that global market as someone who is bilingual and speaks multiple languages. So I have the first scenario for you guys is just we're going to read it out loud and then we're going to respond to it. You guys don't have to write. Is there anyone that would like to read it out loud?
So Senator Ralph Yarborough from Texas said in reference to the Bilingual Education Act, the goal was not to keep my specific language alive. Yarborough said it is not the purpose of the bill to create pockets of different languages through the country, but just to try to make those children fully literate in English. Why is the senator thinking problematic with the growing research regarding the benefits of maintaining the home language?
So he made this statement in the 80s, so that was kind of prior to a lot of the research that we have now. But why do you think that this quote that he gave about this bilingual act that's supposed to be promoting the first language of students, why do you think that it's problematic in what he's saying about the act? to approve that.
You said that the goal is not in regards to giving languages a lot, but just to make children literate in English, which, I mean, yes, but it's good to have your children know how to speak and write English, but at the same time, language is a huge, huge factor in there, though, because I feel like parents are just of so many cultures, and we need to kind of be aware that the majority also, it's good to know multiple languages because when it's a job, having to work with people.
I think that you're a lot of great things, Nisha. Do you want to kind of summarize what you said? Because it would be especially good.
Well, the senator was talking about how the main goal for him is to have students be literate in English in regards to reading and writing, and it's not as important to have the language. Different language literacy, fluency in other languages, but in my opinion, I feel like, yes, it's important to have children literate in English, but at the same time, America consists of so many different cultures and backgrounds, and then it's important to realize that learning more languages not only helps with, like we said before, with students' identity and just be owning their cultural background, but also for career paths, you're going to be working with so many people who are from different backgrounds, and you need to be aware of that, and honestly, you have to know how to speak.
Exactly, and it brings in the culture piece, and it also brings in the kind of the idea of getting someone proficient in reading while still maintaining their kind of their identity and their culture. Kind of as a final scenario, you guys can kind of apply what we've talked about today. I'm just gonna read it for the sake of time, but you have a student in your classroom who is Mexican-American. Her first language is Spanish. When she started her formal education, she was encouraged to speak only English in the classroom. At home, her family only spoke to her in Spanish, and she was discouraged from speaking English around her grandparents who do not speak English. As a result of this inconsistency, the student has become mute. The student is enrolled in your first grade classroom. How do you react, and what is your plan to encourage the student to speak her first language while still fostering her reading and writing skills in English? And you guys can talk about it together, and then one of you can record your response. Writing, you can kind of say that loud because we kind of ran out of time. So Heather, what are you writing? What would you do?
So we talked about as a teacher, how would you react to like still encourage her to speak English and work with it, but also have her able to do it with her language, so Spanish, and have all of those resources for her. So she's encouraged to do both of them, and then try to work with her.
Because there's definitely a disconnect here between communication with her family and the teacher.
Both of them want to just support.
So communication would definitely help there. Mary, what did you write?
Can I write the same thing when I was a kid? Just like Mother's Day, I had to write in English and I write in Spanish. Just like doing good because I need to speak Spanish at the school.
Right, yeah. It's actually a real scenario too. So what did help her in the long run was a communication between her teacher and her family. And so they didn't feel like they were against one another, and more so that they were working together with her to make her achieve better reading. So